任何 Anthony， 對嚟我介紹我個拍檔俾你識 Anthony。
係，
咁少
啊 ，David，
你係 David Chala。喂 ，David 啊，啊呢個我睇到呢個呢啲鼓咧都好特別喎，你可唔可以介紹下？
So basically, this is an African instrument, but it has been transformed in Cuba. We call tumbadoras, and we have different sizes, different tune, like different tone, right? Yeah, different melody. You can do different. This is maracas, yeah.
Okay.
This one is not Cuban, it's Brazilian, but we use a lot in Latin music. It's called chécere.
Yeah.
This one is a güiro, very important in Cuban music, especially to play cha-cha. Yeah. And this one, we can actually call this is the backbone of Cuban music, it's called clave. Very important for Cuban music. We have 5 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cuban clave.
Wow, Anthony, 你覺唔覺得古巴人咧真係充滿音樂嘅細胞嘅，同埋佢哋嘅音樂咧就好似跳舞咁樣。
係啊，聽咗啲音樂都好開心嘅，其實。
係啊。
係咯，咁 David 啊，其實咧古巴離香港咁遠啦，咁香港都好少見到古巴人嘅，咁可唔可以講下點解你會嚟咗香港嘅？
Well, I came to Hong Kong at the end of 2002, and first of all, I came to do some performance, so I found a chance to do some collaboration with a Chinese canto pop album into Cuban music mix. So I decided to stay in Hong Kong because I think Hong Kong is a very active in life entertainer, and then I take Hong Kong as my second home. So, right.
Wow, nice. 好開心啊！聽到佢好中意香港。David 啊，你嚟咗香港都好多年啦，就已經18年啦。其實喺香港可以咧講話係一個東西文化匯合嘅地方啊，但係始終都係一個亞洲嘅城市啊。雖然佢係一個多元文化嘅國際城市啊，咁你點樣喺呢個城市裏頭係發展你嘅事業，同埋點樣喺個生活上面點樣適應唔同嘅文化咧？
I have been in Hong Kong already 18 years, and for me, it's a blessing to be here, especially because being a very cosmopolite country, you can meet people from different cultures, but I think Cubans, they're very easygoing in order to adjust to different things, and then I like to learn and to see different things and new things always, especially I like Chinese food, and I have been very amazing about how Chinese people gather and share things with the family, especially for Chinese New Year. And I think in Cuba, we have not really a lot of influence of Chinese, but we have a small Chinatown in Havana.
Yeah.
And we used to play Tai Chi too when we were kids. Mm-hmm. I remember, we have the first female band and musician in Cuba, in South America. They were mixed Chinese. Mm-hmm. Not many people know that. They call Anacaona. Mm-hmm. They were 12 sisters. Mm-hmm. They are mixed of Chinese. Mm-hmm. So I think, we should appreciate to be in Hong Kong because the place is what it is, and then I love to be here. Mm. But it's not really difficult for me to adjust because I'm easy going, and then I just go with the flow with my music, and then it should be okay.
嗱，雖然音樂係國際嘅 common language 啦，咁其實經過唔同嘅歷史啊或者文化都有佢哋音樂獨特之處啦。咁可唔可以解釋一下古巴嗰個特色咧？
Cuban music has its own character, and then I think it's very unique. One of the characteristics of Cuban music is we have a lot of rhythm. We use a lot of drums, like you see the congas, and then we also use timbales, bongos, maracas, cowbell, many things. So like these ingredients make Cuban music very special. And something else could be a little bit complex sometimes, different with other music, because we use a lot of syncope. Syncopate in music terms is like you don't play always downbeat. It's like one end. So the other thing is Cuban music is very danceable. I think Cuban music is very happy music, energetic, and good vibe. They call actually Cubans the island of music. Because since you are very baby or very young age, we have already musicality in our blood. So we have been raised in this environment all the time. The music is very loud. That is what we call rumba. When you see someone playing drums or even doing something, this is called rumba. Everywhere in Cuba, you have this sense. Everywhere in every corner, every family. Even ladies, when they are pregnant, they go to party and dance. Yeah. So this is one of the special things in Cuban music. It's not only about the rhythm itself. It's ingredients of Spanish influence, African influence, plus the rhythm. It's totally different. But I think in general, it's very good because people love Cuban music. And then even though you don't know how to dance, when you listen to it, you know you have your move.
Yeah.
Especially if you listen to cha-cha or mambo. Nowadays they have something they call salsa, which is very popular worldwide, and many people follow it. This is also like Cuban music, and the dance style too. It's from Cuba.
哇！聽完之後我哋都想去學啊，唔單止音樂，仲跳舞添啊。
OK 喎，David 啊，你而家喺香港啦，咁其實可唔可以講解一下你同亞洲嘅音樂家嘅交流啊？例如你嘅古巴元素加入我哋嘅音樂啊，或者？調翻轉由亞洲嘅音樂元素加翻入個古巴嘅音樂裏面
咧。I have been doing a lot of collaborations and sometimes things like it's a hard work, but having connection, I think people will like to always integrate Cuban element into the music. For example, I have been working in canto pop concerts with some local artists and some famous canto pop singers too, and they always want to have the percussion, Cuban percussion or Latin percussion into the music. Because it makes it more spicy and enhance the music. Like working with locals too, sometimes I get surprised that they are not even Cuban, but they can be able to play the music. Once they learn, they have a passion for it. So I love some of, I mean, not all of them, but because the reality is I don't understand sometimes the Cantonese lyrics. But the music itself, sometimes I get touched. And then I always thinking to do like a collaboration, having some Chinese song into Cuban music style. Which would be interesting because I think it's good and people love it. So in general, I don't get very affected by Chinese music influence or vice versa, but I think the collaboration between both kind of music would be always great.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because it's like a fusion, futuristic, that's another way to say.
Right.
And then I think, I do remember a long time ago, I was in a taxi and I was surprised that the taxi driver was listening to Cuban music.
Really?
This is a song, it's called Vacilón, qué rico vacilón, cha cha cha, and then I find out this is like a commercial, right? But it's a Cuban song.
Yeah.
Another one from Andy Lau's Corazón de Melao, 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 Corazón. This is a cha cha, so this is a Cuban stuff. So some people recognize too, like a Guantanamera, Guajira, so it's Cuban music. And somehow, even before I came to Hong Kong, I think. Some people already have information about Cuban music, but maybe they don't know it's a Cuban music.
Right, right.
So to me, I'm here to expose it and to let people, you know, I am a Cuban, so you can learn more, you can listen to more Cuban music.
Great.
精於打鼓啊，嗱彈琴咧加埋唱歌都有一手噶喎。
咁可唔可以講下你同其他 artist 係咪有啲合作啊、伴奏之類嘅咧
？Actually, piano is my main instrument, and I love it because playing piano you can be able to compose and arrange. So I have been involved in many projects on the canto pop scenes, doing like rearranging songs, Chinese songs into Latin. So I compose, arrange, program, do this kind of stuff, and even with my band.And some other local artists, I do piano and singing too.
Wow.
Hey, David, 剛才你講過啦，就係經常都有機會同本地嘅樂手或者音樂人合作啊。咁我哋好想知道咧，係你同邊幾個樂手合作過，同埋有啲咩難忘嘅經驗咧
？Some of my other work actually has been with the canto pop scenes, like collaborating and performing with artists like Cheng Ho Yao, Kelly Chen, Andy Lau, Justin Lo, Fema, so many of them, and actually doing TV show with Joyce Lee. So I remember too, my last collaboration was an album that has been arranging for Francis Jip. Yeah, and then on the cantopop scenes, normally I do more like percussion. I play my percussion set, congas, timbales, all kind of drums. Mm-hmm. But the like collaboration that was mentioned before, arrangement is more like doing the piano. I have so many great experience, especially when we do like a world tour with different countries. I feel always amazing how people get connected with these artists, especially with the message they're giving. Because I don't understand the language, but I can see the response of the audience, so it's really good, very good. And doing like a big stadium in China, for example, the concerts in China with 50 to 70,000 people. Whoa. So it's always amazing. Wow. It's a very crowd, good crowd.
你作為香港少數嘅古巴音樂人啦，咁你對呢個城市有冇咩願景，同埋你點樣可以將古巴嘅音樂喺亞洲度發揚光大咧？
As the only Cuban musician in Hong Kong, I think I have a mission, and this mission will be more, trying to expose more my culture, my music. But from time to time, I have been doing some musical education, like in some international school. Also, I have been training some of the teachers from the international school to teach this kind of music because they integrate already some, we call some with the Cuban Jara music style into the music program in the school. And I think I should be focused more into this kind of activities, mm-hmm. trying to expose more and bring some people to my knowledge, mm-hmm. and share with them.
Right. 哇 ，David， 我哋咧真係好希望咧喺將來咧可以咧有更多嘅機會咧欣賞到你嘅表演咯。不如咧而家即係我哋請阿 David 再表演多一次俾我哋睇咧，好唔好啊
？Good idea.
Yeah? Okay.
想睇更多精彩嘅内容，快啲下载有线 OTT app 啦！